The man who owned it. How did he turn him into a racist dog?
It's simple.
Find a black wino who desperately needs a drink, or a black junkie who'd do anything for a fix, and then pay them to beat that dog of yours when he was a puppy.
You've got yourself an attack dog.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Come on.
How did he turn him into a racist dog?
By professionals to attack people.
Turn him into a racist dog.
Now that dog has got to be stopped before
he... Turn him into a racist dog.
That dog is sick.
Then he should be cured.
Darling, the people that made him sick made him permanently sick.
Then they should be put to sleep, not the dog.
Oh, come on, Julie, you got a four-legged time bomb.
Then turn him into a racist dog.
You're my last resort. And if you don't help them, they're gonna kill him.
How did he turn him into a racist dog?
They should. They should, miss.
And as a dog grew up, those methodical beatings by blacks planted that seed of fear in him. And that fear became hate, and that hate conditioned him to attack the color black.
That's a white dog!
Of course he's a white dog.
I don't mean his color. He's going to attack and kill black people!
I'll turn him into a racist dog.
What's going on, guys? Welcome back to Madison Bell. Today we're going to talk about a topic that I've heard off and on. You know, people ask me in confidence, and some that people believe and some people don't believe, and some people would like to hear about. If you search it on the internet, you're going to see very little information about it, especially on YouTube. But today we're going to talk about a couple things. The first series of this is going to be about race and dogs. Are dogs racist? And that question comes up and people want to know. I'm not just going to answer it for you. We're going to go through a series of information and then you be the judge of what do you think. So stay tuned. And we're going to kick this out to you, and then you tell us what you think at the end. So before we talk about race with dogs, let's go back further, and let's talk about something very basic and simple first. Dogs is known that they can react to other people's senses. For instance, if I go to walk up on the dog, and the dog senses that I am scared of the dog can become aggressive. They can become in a different manner because I am sweating at the palms behind my ears and I am not as sure of the situation. This happens on both ends. This can actually happen with the owners too. The owners can tighten up on the leash. The owners can also feel some type of way about the individual that they're standing in front of. And latter to the fact, the owners can also not socialize their animals with these certain groups of people. So there's a lot of factors in there before we go straight to the heart of the point. Now, in this topic, we're going to talk about how black people evolve with dogs going back to the last 300-400 years. Now, as we talk about black people and dogs going back the last 300-400 years, we're going to talk about their association with dogs. Starting about 300-400 years ago, dogs were used to capture runaway slaves. Dogs were used to go after any slaves that left their plantation to hunt them down, and they would bite them, run them up a tree, what have you.
Cypher, that Marsha and the bitches send D'Artagnan to nigger heaven.
Marsha! Marsha!
So this connotation left a bad impression on black people. Now we skip forward to the 1950s. Dogs were used in protests to make black people be intimidated. They were actually biting the protesters and attacking them. Now, here we are after about 200-300 years. The idea of dogs in a black household was not a good one. A lot of black people feared dogs. it was passed down from generations that dogs would attack them, especially bigger dogs. Dogs were generally didn't have a liking towards black people. So a lot of black people at that point in time developed a phobia of dogs. They wouldn't get big dogs, they wouldn't get dogs in general, and they would be scared of dogs. So now with them meeting a dog and never having a dog, they have the sweaty palms. They have the sweat behind their ears. Their heart is racing. And the dog can sense this nervous behavior. That is one side of the coin. So this is where this starts to come up. When you look at how dogs respond to black people, you start to look at, you have to go back and look at the history, how dogs were used on black people. And then how that was passed down to generations, all the way to children who had absolutely nothing to do 200-300 years ago, but they're living that genetic curse of how dogs were developed and used on them, around them. So that is part one of how dogs were used on black people, why some black people are scared of dogs, and dogs can sense that behavior coming off black people. So we're gonna go to part two. Now, on the secondly, say that you are not a melanated person and you're a lighter skinned person and you own a dog. And every time you sense you do a involuntary behavior because you don't really have many dark-skinned friends, your dog can sense that. For instance, if you're walking your dog down the street and you see a melanated person and you cross over to the other street, your dog senses you're avoiding that group of people. You start to develop this sense, the sixth sense into your dog is, these are the people we shouldn't be around. We ladder forward, you don't have many melanated people coming inside of your household. You don't really interact with many melanated people. Your dog's not socialized with many dark-skinned people. Your dog starts to sense a behavior, these are the people we don't interact with. So we are casting our judgment of others onto our dogs. If I tighten up my leash every time I see a lighter-skinned person, my dog starts to sense that, hey, we're not supposed to be around those people. There's something wrong. My owner's getting frustrated. My owner's getting nervous. My owner's getting scared. Maybe I should be protecting my owner against these certain people. That is one flip of the coin. So now you have both of those ends going. You have one person that's nervous to be around the dog, and you have one person that's nervous to be around the person, and the dog senses it, all right? In that essence, dogs don't have the ability to be racist. It's just not in there. They don't have, that is a human action that we cast on dogs. We cast our ideology on a dog that a dog must be racist because they don't like these type of people. Honestly, it's just a mirror. Your dog is reflecting who you are and how you feel about certain people. Your dog is reflecting who you are and how you feel about dogs. That's all it is. When you meet a dog is a two-way mirror. So how you feel about it is going to come out the action of the dog. If I don't like dogs, then the dogs will tell the owner, hey, he's not a dog person. If I don't like a certain group of people, the dog will tell those people, my owner doesn't like those type of people. I know these aren't the answers people are willing to hear, but this is the truth about dogs. Now, I will say dogs, if they cannot see the indentations of your face, especially when it's darker at night, it seems that you're wearing a mask, which makes you look more alienated, and the dogs will react to you. This happens a lot with darker skinned people because people can't really see their expression of their face and nose, lips and nose at nighttime. That is a different topic. But this topic is based on you in the daylight, someone as a dog, the dog doesn't like you, you don't like dogs, you're both hitting the middle. And now it seems that dogs don't like black people. You just missed all that scientific data and you added that together. So no, that is not a thing. Dogs are not racist. They do not see race as a color. They respond to how we train them, socialize them. I've trained with hundreds and thousands of dogs. I've trained with people who have dogs that you would other call them rednecks, and their dogs have jumped out their car. They've come straight up to me and we've trained and they've acted like I've known them their whole life. The reason why that is because that person didn't have any type of a way of feeling about me as a black man. They didn't feel a type of way about me. So their dog didn't feel a type of way about me. So, and I wasn't scared to greet the dog and meet the dog. So that is the reaction. So the dog didn't care what color I was. But when you have those elements that are set in their precedence, where someone is nervous of a group of people and a group of people is nervous of dogs, when they meet, it seems like the dog is not liking this group of people. I'll take, for instance, my own personal dog, King. King does not like black people. King does not like white people. King does not like Chinese people. King does not like Spanish people. King does not like Latino people. King does not like French people. King only loves his owner, period. Now, if you meet King and you're not scared of King, regardless of what color you are, he's fine. But if you come with nervous behaviors and all this, it doesn't matter what color you are. He is going to tense up. So the question to what you're answering is, no, King is not racist. He just doesn't like people that are nervous and behaving nervous around him because he doesn't know what they're going to do to him, especially if he's my personal protection dog. So dogs are not racist. This is an ideology we cast on dogs. This is a thing that we feel because our dog always barks at the plumber who's black. The dog always barks at the groomer who's black. Our dog always barks at the lawnmower guy who's black. Our dog always barks at our accounting for our taxes who's black. So we come with this idea that my dog must not like black people, but more importantly, you should look inward and say, do I know a lot of black people? Does my dog socialize with a lot of black people? Does my dog feel away when I hold the leash and I tense up when I see a black person? Do I cross over streets? Do I get nervous? Does my dog smell those pheromones coming out of me that I am nervous about being around black people? And if the answer is truly yes inside, then you know that it's more of you that are casting these ideologies on your dog through senses than your dog actually knowing if they like or dislike black people. Same for black people. If you say, well, that guy's got a bunch of racist dogs, you have to look at it. Are you scared of the dogs? When you see the dogs, are you scared of these dogs? Do you back up? Do your hands get sweaty? Do your back of your neck and your ears get sweaty? Do you change the posture that you are with these dogs? Because if so, the dog senses that you're scared of the dog. So the dog begins to change how they are with you. So before we cast human ideologies on dogs that they're racist, we have to look at our behavior and what we're training our dogs to like and dislike. This can go both ways. This could be a black family who owns a dog who never socializes their dog with lighter skinned people, and then the dog becomes aggressive towards lighter skinned people. This can't flip. This is not just a one-way thing. So you can't think that this is just lighter skinned people, dogs that don't like dark skin. It can be both ways. If you've never socialized your dog with lighter skinned people, you become reactive whenever you see lighter skinned people. You tense up the leash whenever you see lighter skinned people. Your dog is going to get reactive towards lighter skinned people. And then the same group of people will say, well, my dog doesn't like white people. That is not true. That's just all you casting a mirror through your dog straight out to the public. So that's something you should never say. That's kind of a question that is not on the internet that you can't really go Google. I think there's maybe 2-3 videos about this. So I've tried to break this down in a more sensible way for you to understand. I was going to crack out all the data and all that stuff. And I was like, you know what? No one cares about data. I'll try to break it down into a more simpler version. If you would like the data on all the studies that were done with this, I can send it to you if you need facts. But this is the overall concept. Dogs are not racist. People are. And dogs cast their ideology on the dogs. So I'm Madison Bell. I'm Rodriguez Carter. That is the answer to your questions. Dogs are not racist.